Hello friends, welcome to my new data structures and algorithm in Java tutorial series video. Friends, in this tutorial we will discuss how to detect a loop in a linked list in Java. Let's suppose we are given a linked list having 6 nodes, say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and which contains a loop. So here if you see, the head points to the first node points to the second, second points to third, third points to fourth, fourth points to fifth, fifth points to sixth, and sixth points to third. Therefore, you can see that this linked list contains a loop as 3 points to 4, 4 points to 5, 5 points to 6, and 6 points to 3, and again it goes on. And if you see below is the algorithm to detect whether a linked list contains a loop or not. So let's see the demonstration of this algorithm step by step. Now in the first step, we are simply creating the reference of list node by name fast pointer, which is pointing to head. So it looks something like this. So here you see, as head points to this first node, now fast pointer will be referring to this first node. Moving ahead, we'll also create one slow pointer which will refer to the head. So it would look something like this. Moving ahead. Now friends, we are encountering here a while loop. So the basic idea behind this algorithm is, in order to detect this particular loop in a linked list, so what we are doing here is, we know that fast pointer and slow pointer both are pointing to head, so therefore they are at the start position. Now the basic idea behind this algorithm here is, we will move slow pointer one step and we will move fast pointer two steps. And if suppose the linked list doesn't contain the loop, then we know that the last node should point to null. Therefore, we are traversing fast pointer two steps and slow pointer one step, because if linked list contains a loop, then there will be a situation as slow pointer is moving slowly and fast pointer is moving fast. So the fast pointer will never encounter a null value, and there will be a situation where fast pointer will meet the slow pointer because of the loop nature. So here in while loop, we are placing a condition as fast pointer should not be null and fast pointer next should not be null. Now here we know that as the linked list contains a loop, therefore the fast pointer will never be null, and we are checking that fast pointer next is not equal to null, because as we are traversing fast pointer by two positions, we need to make sure that fast pointer next is also not equal to null. And in while loop, you can see we are assigning a value of fast pointer next to fast pointer as we are traversing it two steps. So we need to make sure that fast pointer next should not be null, because if it is null, then we will encounter null pointer exception. Therefore, the condition we are placing is fast pointer should not be equal to null and fast pointer next also should not be equal to null. So currently, if you see, fast pointer is pointing to the node first having data as 1 and its next is also not null. Therefore, the condition in while loop comes out to be true. So in the first step, what we are doing, we are just traversing fast pointer to two steps. So here if you see, we are assigning fast pointer next value to fast pointer. So here fast pointer is pointing to the first node, its next is pointing to the second node, and its next is pointing to the third node. Therefore here we are simply traversing fast pointer by two positions. So it would look something like this. So we have simply traversed fast pointer by two positions. Moving ahead. Now here we are simply traversing slow pointer by one position. So we are assigning slow pointer next value to slow pointer. So slow pointer is currently pointing the first node and its next is pointing to the second node. So we are simply traversing it by one position. So it would look something like this. And then we are simply checking that whether slow pointer is equal to fast pointer or not. So we are doing this step is because there will be a situation where fast pointer will traverse all the node and again meet the slow pointer, because the linked list contains a loop and there is no end to the linked list. So currently slow pointer is pointing to the node second and fast pointer is pointing to the node third. Therefore they are not equal. So the condition in if block comes out to be false. And now we'll again check that whether fast pointer is equal to null or not, and its next is equal to null or not. So fast pointer is pointing to third node, therefore it's not equal. And fast pointer next is pointing to fourth node, therefore it's not equal. So the condition in while loop comes out to be true. And then in the first step, we are simply traversing fast pointer by two positions. So here if you see, fast pointer next is pointing to the fourth node and its next is pointing to fifth node. So we are simply traversing fast pointer from third position to fifth position by assigning fast pointer next value to fast pointer. So it would look something like this. Moving ahead, then we are simply traversing slow pointer by one position by assigning slow pointer next value to slow pointer. So it would look something like this. Moving ahead, now we are again checking whether slow pointer is equal to fast pointer or not. So you can see slow pointer is pointing to third node and fast pointer is pointing to fifth node. Therefore, they are not equal. Hence, the condition in if block comes out to be false. Now we'll again check the condition in while loop. So fast pointer is currently pointing to fifth node, therefore it's not null. And fast pointer next, which is sixth node, is also not null. Therefore, condition in while loop comes out to be true. So in the first step, we are simply traversing fast pointer by two position. And here you can see we are assigning fast pointer next position to fast pointer. So fast pointer next is 6 and its next is 3. So we are simply traversing the fast pointer from 5th position to 3rd position. So it would look something like this. Moving ahead. Now here we are simply traversing slow pointer by 1 position by assigning slow pointer next value to slow pointer. So slow pointer is pointing to third node and its next is pointing to fourth node. So we are simply traversing it by one position. So it would look something like this. Moving ahead, we are again checking whether slow pointer is equal to fast pointer or not. So fast pointer is pointing to third node, slow pointer is pointing to fourth node. Therefore, they are not equal. So the condition in if block comes out to be false. And now we are again checking in the while loop that fast pointer is equal to null or not. So fast pointer is pointing to third node, therefore it's not equal. And fast pointer next, which is fourth node, which is also not null. Therefore the condition in while loop comes out to be true. Now we are simply traversing fast pointer by two positions by assigning fast pointer next value to fast pointer. So here fast pointer is currently pointing to third node and its next is pointing to fourth node and its next is pointing to fifth node. So we are simply traversing fast pointer from third position to fifth position. So it would look something like this. Moving ahead, now we are simply traversing slow pointer by one position by assigning the slow pointer next value to slow pointer. So slow pointer is pointing to fourth node and its next is pointing to fifth. Therefore we are simply traversing it by one position. So it would look something like this. Moving ahead, and now we are checking whether slow pointer is equal to fast pointer or not. So friends, here slow pointer is equal to fast pointer. Therefore, we are very much sure that this linked list contains a loop. So the condition you see in the if block comes out to be true. And we simply return true because we have identified that this linked list contains a loop. So friends, here we saw the demonstration of the algorithm. Now let's go to Eclipse and see the working code. So friends, in my previous tutorial, I had created one class by name singly linked list. Now this class has a list node by name head, which is an instance variable. And we also created one inner class by name list node. You can watch my previous tutorials in order to understand more about how to implement a singly linked list. So in this tutorial, we will write a code which we saw in the slide and see it's working. So first I will create one method as public boolean, and let's say I give method name as contains loop. So basically I will write the code inside this method contains loop, and it will return me back a boolean value that whether the linked list contains a loop or not. So in the first step, we'll create a fast pointer reference variable and we'll assign the value of head to it. In the second step, we'll create a slow pointer and we'll assign the value of head to it. Moving ahead, now we'll create one while loop which we saw in the slide, and we'll provide condition as fast pointer should not be equal to null and fast pointer next should not be equal to null. And in the while loop, we'll traverse fast pointer by two positions. So we are simply assigning fast pointer next to next value to fast pointer. So we are simply traversing fast pointer by two positions. And then we are simply traversing slow pointer by one position. So we are assigning slow pointer next value to slow pointer. And then we are providing an if check that if slow pointer is equal to fast pointer, then simply return true. And it means we have identified that the linked list contains a loop. And after the while loop, if suppose we haven't found any loop, then we simply return false. So friend, this is the algorithm which detects whether the linked list contains a loop or not. Now we'll also create one more method which will actually create a linked list having a loop. So public void create a loop in linked list. So in this method we'll create few nodes, we'll assign them in such a way that it will create a loop inside a linked list. So friends, in the slide we saw an example where the linked list contains 6 nodes and which was forming a loop. So I will simply replicate that example here. So for that I will create list node, say first equals new list node, and I give value as 1. Now I will create 5 more list nodes. So I'll just give them value as 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and I'll change the name as second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth. Now as we saw in the slide that head points to the first node, therefore we'll simply assign value of first to head. And we also know that first next was second, second next is third, third next is fourth, fourth next is fifth, fifth next is sixth. And in order to create a loop, the example we saw in the slide was sixth node next refer to the third node. So here we simply assign value of third to sixth next. So sixth dot next, and we'll assign value of third to it. So this will create a linked list containing a loop where first is pointing to second, second is pointing to third, third is pointing to fourth, fourth is pointing to fifth, fifth is pointing to sixth, and sixth is pointing to third. So it will create a loop. Now in the main method, let's test the working of this algorithm. So in the first step, we have simply created an instance of singly linked list. Now in the second step, I will call this method create a loop in linked list. So create. So after this method gets executed, the head will be pointing to a linked list containing a loop. So in the third step, we'll simply print the output of contains loop on the console. So here we'll simply call contains loop method, and whatever the outcome of contains loop is, we'll simply print it on the console. So currently you can see the linked list which we have created in this create a loop in linked list method has a loop. So the contains loop method should return true. So if I run the code, so you can see it returned true because the linked list which we created in this method had a loop. Now here suppose I don't assign the value of third to 6.next. So if I comment this line, then we know that this linked list is not containing a loop. So if I run the code now, you can see it returned false because here we have break the link in the linked list which was actually making a loop. So friends, this was the algorithm to detect whether a linked list contains a loop or not. I hope you like this video. Please like, comment, share, and subscribe my YouTube channel. Thanks, have a nice day.